Hi, welcome. This is Mike Klinghammer. I'm the president of the City Council. We're here today to talk about the events and actions that took place at last night's City Council meeting. Last night was Tuesday, March 20th, and we're going to have a quick wrap-up of the activity that happened yesterday. First thing that we did was had a public hearing concerning the five TIF projects, the ongoing TIF projects that are currently in place in the city. Those five projects are Elm Point Redevelopment Area. That's the part of town that's just east of Elm Street along the 370 corridor. The St. Charles County Convention Center Redevelopment Area. That, of course, is the area on Highway 70 at the Convention Center. The West 370 Redevelopment Area, also known as Fountain Lakes. That's the area that is to the west of Elm Street along 370. And then we have the amended St. Charles Center redevelopment area that's better known as Bass Pro, and the Plaza at Noah's Ark redevelopment area. That, of course, is the Noah's Ark site, the old Noah's Ark site that we have the new building that's going up, and the next two buildings are soon to follow. Those projects, for the most part, have been running along. They've accomplished most of what they set out to do, and we had a public hearing to go over the results of those TIF projects. The other significant activities that we took place was we authorized the St. Charles Lions Club to operate the farmers market down on Main Street again this year. That's been a long-standing tradition during the spring and summer and going into the early fall. That's every Saturday morning, gets started about at 7 o'clock in the morning. And we have lots of local farmers that bring their produce in, as well as their handcrafted jams and jellies and marmalades and all the fun stuff that goes along with that. The rest of it was pretty routine business. We also passed, though, a resolution which approved the new comprehensive plan. The first comprehensive plan that we did, or the one that we're working under currently, was first done in 2002, and we updated it for 2012. We took that existing plan, we incorporated the new concepts and ideas that are going on currently, and we're revising it into a much more user-friendly version of the plan itself. So we adopted that after it came with a positive recommendation from the Planning and Zoning Board. We have several announcements that we'd like to make also. First off, on Saturday at noon, the Shriners and the Moolah Parade is going to occur down on Riverside Drive. Our mayor, Sally Faith, is actually going to lead the parade riding on an elephant. So. That should be a lot of fun. That parade in particular is very family oriented. Plenty of clowns and of course the Shriners riding around in their little cars. Again, that's on Saturday, March 24th at noon on Riverside Drive. Also, I want to make the announcement on the third Friday of every month. So this Friday will be the third Friday at between noon and 6. The group has a recycling effort down at the arena, the family arena parking lot, for all the electronic goods that you may have. This is an opportunity to keep those items out of our landfills. It goes to a good organization that actually pulls a lot of the electronic components out. There are things, there's heavy metals in a lot of our electronics that we really don't want getting back into into landfills and eventually settling back into the earth. This is an opportunity to take those out, keep them out of the landfills, and pull those dangerous materials out. Also coming up is on the week of April 9th through the 13th, we have our free yard waste pickup. This is a fun time of the year. Everything's turning green again. It's time to cut back the trees and the gardens and get rid of all the dead leaves from the winter. And to help our citizens do that, we have a free yard waste pickup that's scheduled both in the spring and then in the fall. Of course, the spring one, like I said, is going to be from the week of April 9th through the 13th. And it's whatever your regularly scheduled yard waste pickup, during that week, that's the time that they'll be on your street. If you don't know when your yard waste pickup date is, you can go to the city's website, and there is a very easy-to-use map that shows the different areas of town and when the yard waste pickup is for that particular time. Generally, it's the day before your trash pickup date. So if your trash pickup date is on Tuesday, then generally speaking, the yard waste pickup date would be on Monday. There are a few exceptions to that. So again, if you don't know for certain, go to the city's website at stcharlescitymo.gov, and there's a very easy to use map on that. The other thing that we talked about last night was the how to do the sidewalks, the handicap ramps on Main Street. As people know, we have brick sidewalks on Main Street, and how to incorporate the ADA accessibility to those ramps is something that we took a long and hard look at. We want to make sure that the sidewalks are safe, first of all. That's the most important part. But we also wanted to find a way to incorporate it so that it looks right and appropriate in the historic district. Couple months of talking about it and looking at different alternatives that we could do, we settled down on a system that will incorporate both brick pavers, what they call the truncated domes, that's a little kind of a rub strip that's right where you meet the street, and some concrete ribbons that will clearly delineate where the sidewalk grade changes and starts dipping down to the grade changes so that it meets the street. We think that is going to be the best alternative. It incorporates, like I said, both brick and concrete, so that the ramps will be easily accessible for everyone. That pretty much takes care of it. Like I said, we had a very quick meeting last night. If anybody has any questions or comments about anything, please use the city's website. It's very, we've been spending a lot of time on updating our website and making it more user-friendly. Again, the website for the city is stcharlescitymo.gov. Thank you very much. Look forward to the next update after the next city council meeting. Have a good day.